Algorithm and program for factorial. Here first flowchart. Flowchart is a one of the standard representation of algorithm. Here first I will explain flowchart, then I will go to program. Here this is a oval shape. By using oval shape we start the flowchart. Next input statement or input symbol. This is a parallelogram. Parallelogram we use for to input. Here we have to enter the one value. Assume that value is 5. Now n value is 5. It is an input symbol. Now assume that n value is 5. Now initialize the starting values of I and f. The initial value of I is 1 and f value is 1. Here f is there. You concentrate on f. N is 5. Assume that n value is 5. I is 1. 1 is less than or equal to n. Yes, true. Because 1 is less than or equal to 5. If it is true, then control goes to this statement. Here for arithmetic operation, we use for rectangles. For condition, rhombus. Here, what is the value of f? Initial value is 1. I value is 1. 1 into 1, 1. 1 again assigned to f. Now, again f value is 1. After I plus plus, I become 2. Then once again control evaluate the condition is once again this condition is true because I value 2 even the 2 is less than or equal to 5. So again true. Control once again comes to the statements and f is equal to f into I. Already f value is 1, I is 2, 1, 2, 2, 2 is assigned to f again. Here I value become 3 after I plus plus, then control once again evaluate the condition. Here once again it is true because I value is 3, 3 is less than or equal to 5. If it is true, then control comes to this statement. F is equal to f into I. What is the value of f now? 2. Now I value is 3 actually. 2, 3 is 6, 6. Now f value is 6. Here I value 4. Control once again evaluate this condition. 4, I value is 4. According to that value, again true this. The control comes to the statement. F value is 6. I is 4. 6, 4 is 24. This is the 24. Now here now 4 after I plus plus it become 5. In next round, F value 24. 24 into 5, 120. Then I become 6, here false, over factorial, 5 factorial is 120. It means factorial of 5 is 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. If you multiply 1 to 5 all the numbers, then we get the result. Now result is 120. Then if it is false, when I value is 6, then control goes to false statement, display F. Now this value will be displayed on the monitor, then it is stopped. It is actually flowchart. Next, pseudocode. Pseudocode also standard algorithm, standard representation of algorithm. This is the same thing. Once you understand any one flowchart or pseudocode, you can write program also very easily. Here, first start step, second step is to read the n value. We have to enter one value here. Now assume that n value is 5. Then again, same procedure is there here. Everything is same is there. If it is till this is true, the control evaluate here only. If it is false, this condition is false, control goes to the after the statement, which is after the while. Display f, the value which is you get in f, that value we have to print here, then stop. Next, program. In the program also same thing. Here we have declare I and n. Here FL is long integer because factorial result may be come large values. For example, 5 factorial 120, okay, 10 factorial it will come in lakhs. The lakhs value in integer cannot store in lakhs. That's why I'm taking here long int. Long int variable take 4 bytes memory, it can store very long numbers also. When we run this program, we get the message enter the number, then we have to enter one number. That number is scanned by scanf and assigned to n. the value which is, if we want to find factorial, that value is we have given in n. Here I is we have taken for loop repetition purpose to control the loop. Now what is the value of I? 1. Here condition is true because you assume that n value is 5, I is 1, 1 is less than or equal to 5, condition is true, then control immediately, the statement will be executed. 1 already FL is 1 here, I value also 1 here, 1 into 1, 1 again assigned to F, F value 1. Now I value after 1, it becomes 2. After executing this statement, control goes to the I++. After I++, I value become 2. After this, control once again evaluate this condition. If it is once again true, this statement is once again re-executed. FL is 1, 1, 2, 2. The 2 is assigns to F. Now FL is 2. I is increment by 1. It become 3. FL is 2 already. 2, 3, 6. Next it become 4. Already in F, 6 is there in last step, 6, 4, 24, that 24 into next I is 5, 24, 5, 120, then it is then it is 6, then it falls here. After falls here, then control comes to the next statement, which is after the for loop, factorial of percentage D is equal to percentage LD. This specifier for F, this specifier for N. Here in place of this specifier n value we get, that is 5. In place of percentage LD we get F value, that is 120. Because F is a long integer, that's why we use here long integer specifier. Thank you.